Might just move the CGTuts logo up a little bit. We can just copy the nodes. So if we go to the curve editor and clear the graph, grab this one here, and then with the Y, we can delete all previous keyframes and move this one up. Actually, it'd be better to look at what we're doing based off of the non-inverted one. Oops, just want to solo Y, delete those, and bring it up a bit. Okay, something like that. And then we can just copy, delete, paste, and go minus one. That was the wrong card to do that to. There we go. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Let's see what happens when the AETuts logo comes on. That's looking nice. Okay, so now what do we need to do? Well, let's add... first let's create a mat of anything CG that is in this scene so that we can just soften it slightly and add some grain to that. So we could do that by grabbing the mat and merging this mat with the CG, sorry, the 2D cards. And if we hit one, we can see that we have a nice mat of everything in the scene that's CG. So we can now, let's say, if we have a look at this, add a soften and mask this. If we just plug this in, we can mask this based off of that, mask it based off its alpha. So if we just say soften this way too much, we're masking it based on the alpha of the mask, which is currently not working for some reason. Actually, it is working because you'll see that the background, which is live action footage, is not being affected by the soften. So we can soften it. That's probably a bit too much. And it's always a good idea to look at the composite at 100% when you're deciding how much to soften by. So that's definitely too sharp, that's too soft, so let's go 0.3. And now let's add in some grain. I'm going to read in some stock grain that I have, some HV40 grain. That's the camera that this was shot on. And let's have a look at this. Let's reformat this to the format and let's grade it. It's a bit hard to see at the moment. Let's multiply, change the black point maybe. Actually, maybe change the... offset. So if we can now see the grain a bit more intensely. Might just multiply it a bit more. Cool, so that's more intense now, and we can basically go M and A inside of B. So if we went A in B, we can see that the grain is only in the areas where we have CG. So if we were to just go A plus B, the grain would only be in the right areas. So if we have a look here and we say disable the grain, D to disable, we can see the difference that that's making. It's still extremely subtle, too subtle. So we could either grade it even more. Let's grade it and offset it. And there we can see, because the grain is from the exact same camera, it looks very nice. the CG looks like it belongs in the scene. So the other thing we need to do is remove the distortion from we removed the distortion in the first part of the tutorial so that we could match move it more accurately. We need to reintroduce that distortion, and because we're using PFTrack, we could export a node from PFTrack that basically allows us to easily reintroduce that distortion using the PF Barrel plugin. So that comes with PFTrack, and if you're running Nuke 7, you need to download the compiler from Nukepedia, otherwise it won't work in Nuke 7. So once you've done that, you can just hit X and type in PF Barrel, and not sure where that went. There it went at the bottom, and PF Barrel will be expecting the exact same size composition as the raw footage that was match moved. So we need to reformat this back to the 1960x1103, and then with this PF Barrel we can run a file. So in Refraction, this is our project's directory inside of cameras. We exported the chessboard PF Barrel, and if we double click on that, we'll see that the distortion is perfectly reintroduced. Excellent. And we're back to 1920x1080, but the CG was rendered for 720, so let's reformat this back to 1280x720, if there's a preset for that. No, there isn't, so let's just make a new one. Call this 720p. And there we have a 720p image. And it looks great, and we have this lovely refraction with our 2D elements. And to render this, we just need to add in a right node by hitting W, and then you want to use the RGB channels and save this to here. And I'm going to make a new folder and call this Nuke Render, and we'll call this, let's hit save, and the name will be Fraction, and you need to go percentage sign 03d.tiff. So that's just the frame padding for the image sequence. And if you type in .tiff, it knows you want to use a .tiff. No compression, thank you. 8 bits, and this is all good. So we can render this. Might take a little while. That's the end of the tutorial. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.